At first glance, it resembles a spacecraft more than anything else. But this is a research sub that has combed the seas, doing everything from medical research to ship and aircraft recovery.
We have an array of light systems on the sub, so you could turn on whichever light you need.
Jimmy Nelson used to spend about 170 days a year on this sub, the Johnson C. Link submersible, as it's known. It's now retired at Florida Atlantic University's Harbor Branch Oceanographic Institution.
All right. Ready to go.
Ready to go.
But other manned sea vehicles might be next in line to aid in the Malaysia Airlines search.
If this submersible or another submersible can get to where the wreckage is, how effective do you think it could be in the recovery effort?
Very effective.
This is a view of this very submersible in the Atlantic Ocean. It can go 3,000 feet deep, but like all research subs, is slow. It only travels just over 1 mile per hour when searching. The sub was called to duty in 1986 after the Space Shuttle Challenger exploded, and it recovered some of the wreckage from the ill-fated shuttle.
We have the capability of lifting around 1,000 pounds of weight to the surface.
In the very front of the submersible, a tool called a manipulator, which does the important work of grabbing, scooping, and sucking up samples that are recovered.
This sub is about 24 feet long. It's also about 11 feet tall, and it weighs about 28,000 pounds. It has enough oxygen and emergency provisions aboard for the people to survive underwater for up to 5 days.
There is also a back cabin on the submersible called the aft observation chamber. A crew member who keeps an eye on the submersible's vital signs and another scientist share that back area, which is only about 5.5 feet by 3 feet.
So, just to give our viewers an idea of how tight it is, this is how you're sitting. This is how I'm sitting. And you could be here for hours.
But during those hours, this is what's taking place.
So we fire up the sonar system and it does a sweep and it paints us a picture as it spins around 360 degrees on if there's any solid targets on the bottom, it'll beep and it'll kind of paint a small picture of what it looks like. Then we could go ahead and motor that way.
The use of high-tech unmanned underwater vehicles is increasing. But Jimmy Nelson says when looking for wreckage, manned submersibles offer an important dimension.
So you're saying that sometimes just having a human being able to look around the corner of your eye can spot things that an unmanned submersible cannot spot.
Correct.
This submersible will not be going, but others could soon be sent into action in the Indian Ocean, underwater, in an effort to solve a mystery. Gary Tuchman, CNN, Fort Pierce, Florida.